affect air quality. For materially, what we consider would affect air quality materially, would be required to demonstrate how the scheme affects quality and climate change. So we are working with that. But I can update you further on my update.
Thank you very much. That's really good to hear that there is actually something that we are doing locally in Liverpool as well that's very specific to us. Thank you. I'm sorry, we are not taking questions from the public anymore. Because
just to add to that, over 100 units we should be doing it to everyone. We're in a climate emergency. We shouldn't just be doing it for 100 units plus.
Okay. We have to stick to this now in terms of, okay, what's important with the written responses is that we are considering them, and definitely we are taking these things into consideration, and on the basis of questions from public and the answers, we will be setting our agendas as well and seeing what matters the most. So I very much appreciate all the questions from public that are brought here, because they are in a way teaching us as well what we need to be thinking about and what we need to be doing. So please be assured that I am very carefully reading through these questions and setting the agenda according to that, which I believe our cabinet member is doing as well, and as well as the officers and the members of this committee. I would really ask you to do read through these questions and answers very seriously and to think about them. Okay, so we have Councillor Dunn still on this, and then we should move on to the next item of agenda.
It's just a question about the poor foundations, really. I don't know if anyone being sponsors. Obviously, it's council business. It's the way they build the properties and the stuff actually in the properties, like the boilers and stuff like that. Is that actually eco-friendly? Is that actually helping the environment?
In answer, I do refer to that. I have had direct conversations with them. They did actually want to be an active, proactively asking, which is absolutely welcome. But again, you know, you can have the cabinet member for housing, can be asked to come to this committee or of the officer from their knowledge if you want more specific information that might be useful to the committee further forward.
Okay, thank you. Moving on to our next item on agenda, which is the task groups update. It was agreed at the last meeting that we should have specifically the update from the built and natural environment. Unfortunately, Councillor Alison Clark has had to send her apologies, but I hope that Samantha will be able to give us an update. And then we also will have an update from waste resources and energy, and that's within the Chris Brown. Will you be able to give us an update on that? Okay, and I suppose Chris as well, yeah? Okay, thank you very much. So Samantha.